Well, good morning, church. Go ahead and stand to your feet all over the building this morning. If you would, step out into the aisles and greet someone. Welcome them to Christ Fellowship Church, home of the North Georgia Revival, week number 83, somebody. As we prepare to close those doors, so good to have you this morning. We want to welcome all those watching by Facebook Live and tuning in live stream. If you have your Bibles, would you grab it real quick? Let's go to Hebrews chapter 1. The view is beautiful from up here. I said the view is beautiful from up here. You look lovely this morning. Elbow somebody, say you smell good too. You smell good too. Hebrews chapter 1. If you'd find yourself in a place of reverence. If you don't have your Bible, it's okay. We brought one for you. We'll read it for you. Hebrews chapter 1. Did I mention it's week 83? 83. Hebrews chapter 1, verse 7. I'll be reading out of the English Standard Version. Of the angels, he says, he makes his angels winds and his ministers a flame of fire. But of the Son, he says, your throne, O God, is forever and ever. The scepter of uprightness is the scepter of your kingdom. You have loved righteousness and hated wickedness. Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness beyond your comparisons. And you, Lord, laid the foundation of the earth in the beginning, and the heavens are the work of your hands. They will perish, but you will remain. And you, Lord, laid the foundation of the earth in the beginning, and the heavens are the work of your hands. They will perish, but you remain. They will all wear out like a garment, like a robe. You will roll them up like a garment. They will be changed, but you're the same, and your years will have no end. And to which of the angels has he ever said, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies a footstool for your feet? Verse 14. Are they not all ministering spirits sent out to serve for the sake of those who are inheriting salvation? He's talking about the angels. He said, are they not all ministering spirits sent out to serve for your sake and my sake, for the sake of those who are to inherit salvation? This past weekend, I got a message from a lady. She's been here a couple of times, and she usually sits over here, and she'll do sign language for the hearing impaired. And she sent me a message, and she said, hey, Pastor Marty, you really don't know me. I came to interpret for deaf people several weeks ago, one night at the revival. Anyway, I just want to give you a heads up that I'm bringing an autistic friend of mine. His name is Houston. He's 23. Up until a year ago, he was considered nonverbal, and his mother had never had a two-way conversation with him. Think about that. She discovered how to communicate with him through a letter board, which spells out everything he wants to say. It's a slow, tedious way to communicate, but we have discovered some amazing things about this Houston. Number one, he's brilliant. Two, he's got a rock-solid foundation in a relationship with Jesus Christ. They discovered this. Three, very important, he's autistic, nonverbal. Three, he can see the spiritual realm. He sees angels. He has incredible gifts, this young man, not common to man. He is still, however, nonverbal. But he's coming, believing God to heal him completely. This is a picture of Houston. I think we have a picture of him in the water. This is Houston. He stood in that water over there, and he communicated by touching letter after letter after letter. Monday, I get this. Thank you so much for setting things up to accommodate Houston last night. He really loved being there with you all, and he said, It's wonderful. Heavenly. Listen. It's wonderful. Heavenly. Angels are telling angels to answer prayer. His mother said, Houston, how many angels are there? Houston replied, to tell how many angels, well, it's as many as can fill the room. So many, the angels stand waiting to get in. Lights were turned off, he said. The lights were turned off. Now, y'all were here. You know the lights were on. He said, lights were turned off, but darkness can't extinguish the shine from the angels. He said, the water emanating angels and glory like he had never seen. If you were in the water with us, there was five or six in the water. He would stand and look at the water. As we were trying to communicate, he would stand and look at the water. She said, he sees in the spiritual realm. He saw angels all over this room. And they were waiting to get in, and they were telling other angels how to answer specific prayers. Hebrews 1:14. Angels, are they not ministering spirits sent on your behalf? Are they not all ministering spirits sent on your behalf that are filling this room even now, saying, I've got that one, and I've got that one. You take this one, and you take that one, and you go to war for this one. And angel, you over there, you take this whole section. There's somebody praying for you. There's angels among us this morning. They are watching out for you. They are sent as ministering spirits for you. In every situation you brought in, so no matter what happens today, you can say this. Surely somebody stood in my defense. There are angels here. Can we lift our hands? If you'd make your way out into the aisles as we begin to worship, would you make your way down front? You may have to say, excuse me, angel, I need room to worship, because they're everywhere. He said, I see them, and they're full. It's full. The room is full of angels, and they're ministering to you and for you. And so, heaven, we just join you right now. Heaven, we join you, because angels are around the throne, and they're saying, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was, who is, and who is to come. Come on, holy, holy, holy. Holy are you, Lord. Holy, righteous, and lovely are you, Lord. We honor you today, King Jesus, and we join with all the angels, and we say, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Oh God. It's extravagant. It doesn't. Will never come.
Now is ended in the kingdom of light, in the kingdom of light, forever under your dominion. You're the king of my life, you're the king of my life. You reign above it all, you reign above. The work was finished. God, you poured out your life just to give us new life. Now from the lips of the forgiven, hear an anthem arise, 'cause Jesus, you're alive. You reign above it all, you reign. Sent the darkness running out of an empty grave, now seated alone in glory, enthroned on the highest praise. You sent the darkness running out of an empty grave, now seated alone in glory, enthroned on the highest praise. You sent the darkness running out of an empty grave, now seated alone in glory, enthroned on the highest praise. You sent the darkness running out of an empty grave, now seated alone in glory, enthroned on the highest praise. You reign above it all, you reign above. Running out of an empty grave, I'm seated. an empty grave, now seated alone in glory, enthroned on the highest praise. You sent the darkness running out of an empty grave, now seated alone in glory, enthroned on the highest praise. You sent the darkness running out of an empty grave, seated alone in glory, enthroned on the highest praise. You sent the darkness running, you reign above it all, Jesus. Oh, you reign above it all, you reign above my situations, you reign above my circumstances. Jesus, you reign above sickness. Oh, you reign above disease. Oh, Jesus, you reign above cancer. You reign above fear. You reign above doubt. You reign above worry. Oh, you reign above it all, Jesus. It's nothing higher. Oh, there's nothing higher. There's no one greater. Oh, there's no one greater, Jesus. There's no one greater. There's nobody like. Nobody like.
Glory, for you.
death could not hold, fell torn before silence the bones of sin and grave. The heavens are roar, praise of you glory, for you are raised to life again. You have no rival, you have no equal, now and forever, God, you reign. Yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory, yours is the name above all names. 'Cause you have no rival, and you have no equal, now and forever, God, you reign. 'Cause yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory, yours is the name above all names. What a powerful name it is, what a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a powerful name it is, oh, nothing can stand against. What a powerful name.
Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Father, we give you the room. We give you the room. Holy Spirit, come and have your way. No pretense. No barrier. Zero limitation. Father, we're all hurting, bleeding, desperate, broken. We don't need another service, another message. Another worship set. But God, we need you. So radical, so strong. God, it shakes us in our very core. It contorts our ideology, our mindset, our presuppositions about who you are and what you can do in this age. Lord, that it loosens our theological understanding. Untie the bolts today. Oh God, reclaim your church. And Lord, we repent of what we have made. 60 minutes of nothing. 60 minutes of talk and singing with no power. God, we will not apologize for your extravagancy and your display of power and Lord, your overwhelming conviction that draws us closer. And we will not apologize for our exuberant display of emotion and praise for the one who came and died and bled for me and on the third day came back. I will not apologize for being over the top in my expression back to you, for your over the top display of love for me. You are worthy of every syllable that comes out of my mouth, every jump that my feet partake in, every uplifted hand, every shout of praise. You are worthy of it all. Yes. And we hold nothing back for you. For you are good and worthy. And every living soul watching on Facebook and in this room will all say amen and amen. Give a shout unto the Lord this morning. Come on, give him praise. Come on, give him praise. Whoa. I want us to sing, Annalise, Death Could Not Hold Him. And I want you to dial into that for the next 3 to 4 minutes, and you need to hear this. We have literally no idea what's available to us and what God wants to do in this place this morning and tonight. You have no idea how he's standing on the line and he says, if you will let me, I will come in. Yeah. I was going to do this tonight, but Cal, where are you? Where are you, Cal? Come quickly. Where's Cal? From Detroit. He is in the bathroom. Wait, maybe until he gets out of the bathroom. That's so embarrassing, isn't it? That, okay, Cal, could you not hold it? Could you not hold it? I want us to sing this song. The last 2 to 3 minutes. That death could not hold him.
His death could not hold. Mm-hmm. Fell torn before. Silence the boast of sin and grace.
Here we go, here we go.
The heavens are roar. Yeah. Praise of your glory. Yeah. For you are raised to life again. Cause you have no rival. You have no equal. God, you reign. Oh, yours is the kingdom.
Praise God. Praise God. Cal, come on up here. Almost 1,000 people know that you've been in the bathroom. Is everything all right?
Everything's okay.
All right. Tell everybody where you are.
From Detroit. I came down with my wife and some friends from our church because we heard that the Lord's walking here, and we wanted to meet him tonight in the waters.
Yes, sir. A few weeks ago, someone from your area came down to be baptized in proxy. That means they're getting baptized on behalf of someone that could not make it. And I know that may be foreign to our thoughts, but we've seen miracles happen when people get baptized on behalf of others. And so take just a minute to tell about those two situations.
Yeah, some dear friends came down, and in their small church, they have a little baby who was born, never home, 7 months in the hospital because his lungs would not inflate. And, of course, mother and grandfather in great distress. And then that same woman who was sending in proxy, her brother-in-law had late-stage esophageal cancer with a large lump. And she stood in. And a week afterwards, she started seeing on her text stream from the mother that something was going on with the baby. And so what happened was the baby was pawing at its oxygen mask, and the nurses decided to give it a slight break and adjusted the mask off its mouth. Lungs inflated. Never to be back on a baby's okay to this day. That was 4 weeks ago. And then her brother-in-law, who was resistant to come down, she invited, "Would you like to come down? We're going down to meet the Lord for healing." And he didn't want to come. Lives in Pennsylvania. He went to the doctor, and the lump was gone.
Thank you, Cal. You have no rival. You have no equal. You have no rival. You have no equal. These are unprecedented days in the life of what God is doing, not only here at the North Georgia Revival, but literally all over the world. But there is a pocket of glory right now in this building. That we hear reports of this every week of what God is doing and has done. I would do whatever I had to do to be back tonight. I know all of you probably will, but be back tonight. It starts at 5 o'clock for prayer. 6 o'clock, the worship service begins. Pastor David Edmondson from Covenant Connections will be bringing the word. Do whatever you have to do. There's a level of glory that is ever increasing. Don't miss it. On your way back to your seat, shake about 3 hands and tell them, "Don't miss tonight. Don't miss tonight. Don't miss tonight. Don't miss tonight." This morning to make a very important announcement. Our middle school youth pastor and Anthony and his wife Katrina is over here to my left and to your right. But would you welcome Anthony come to the platform?
All right, so our Be Known weekend is coming up. It's a small group weekend. It's November 8th through the 10th. Registration opens today. The cost is only $60. You can start paying payments now if you'd like, or you can pay the whole thing in full. It's for all of our 6th through 12th grade students. We'll be out in the foyer. There'll be a table out there with all the registration information. And also, we're still looking for a few host homes for that weekend, just to invite 8 to 10 students into your house. It's a a unique way to give back to the kids in this church. And we'll be having a short informational meeting about what that's all about in the KINEO 2 room immediately following the service.
All right. Okay, thank you. I'm just so excited about our youth ministry. Chase and Bailey, Anthony and Katrina, our middle school and high school ministry. Thank God for them. So continue to pray for them and as they lead our young people. I want to make a couple announcements before we open up the word and then we give out our diplomas to our KINEO Ministry Training Center graduates today. I want to have the church to be sure to be in prayer that this Thursday, a team of about 40 to 50 people will be traveling to Washington, D.C. to host the North Georgia Revival on the National Mall, right there in the shadow of the White House, the shadow of the Washington Monument, and also in the shadow of the Houses of Congress. Please be much in prayer. It's going to be a significant historical event as we're going to baptize on the National Mall. Come on, let's give God praise. Yeah. For those of you that are going and are interested, there's an itinerary and frequently asked questions. It'll come up on the screen where you can go. And if you will type in the bit.ly right there, all caps, right there at the bottom. If you will type that in, we would appreciate it. It will answer all of your questions. For those that are going, and also those that are here, this is a non-political event. This is not a political event. We're not going up there to make a statement in any regard other than our nation needs God, needs revival. So this is not a pro-Democrat, pro-Republican, pro-libertarian event. So if you're planning on packing any political gear to make a statement, just unpack it because we're not going to have that conversation. That's not why we're there. Republicans and Democrats have had this nation for 240 years and look where it has gotten us. And so we need a move of God. And God is neither Republican or Democrat. Am I clear? Am I okay? I don't mean to upset anybody, but he's just pro-repentance. He's pro-brokenness. He's pro-holiness. All right? Okay. All right. That's all I need to say about that. But be much in prayer, please, for our team that will be going. Let's stand to our feet. Let's receive our offering today. Ushers, will you come forward? I feel the presence of God in this room. Tonight, I will be taking a flight to Louisville, Kentucky. Been asked the last week or so to preach and teach to several hundred pastors that are gathering together at Bob Rogers Church. I need you to cover me in prayer. I'll be leaving after this evening, or sometime tonight, and I get there really, really late, and I have to preach in the morning, and then have to be in New Orleans in the evening of Monday. So please be much in prayer. I was in Peachtree City last night. They baptized to 1:40 in the morning. 1:40, a move of God is happening south of Atlanta. So please be in prayer for us, myself, my family, our team. Let's give sacrificially this morning. Let's give recklessly. One of the signs that I've talked to people in that have had moves of the Lord, they've all said that when revival and glory hits your church, people are so generous and reckless in their giving that blessings just begin to fall on the people of God. You cannot have the glory of the Lord like He is here and not experience His blessings. Amen? And so we want to give today to continue to fund the work of the Lord here at Christ Fellowship. Lord, we give not out of obligation, but Lord, out of generosity, out of obedience. Lord, we're paying it forward. We're paying it forward. Yeah. you touch and bless your children as we seek your face and come after your heart. May we seek your smile and look into the glimmer of your eye. And all that we have is yours. Everything. Bless this time of giving in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You may be seated in the house. I want to encourage you. I want to encourage you to grab your Bibles, and I need my Bible right there, if you would, Karen. Thank you. And I want to encourage you to grab your Bibles. I have a few comments that I want to make. What God is doing. Galatians chapter 6. I want to say how proud I am of the KINEO graduates this morning and their commitment to know more of the Lord, to experience Him in all of His fullness and all of His glory. But I need to say about 8 to 10 minutes of some remarks that I think will help set the stage for what God's going to do this morning as we bestow our diplomas on our graduates. Galatians chapter 6. I've been talking about over the last several weeks about deposit. Everybody say deposit. This may not seem to you to be a revival message or a message that resonates with people when we're experiencing unprecedented glory, but I think it is after the heart of God this morning. If a congregation or a church is not spiritually grounded, there is no way that they can host the presence of God long term. Can I get an amen? And I've been speaking on the last two Sundays about deposits. We all know the significance of deposits in the natural, right? We know that every paycheck that you get, every blessing of that kind monetarily, that you make a deposit, right? You make a deposit into your account. Now, I don't know if anybody here doesn't have a bank account. Maybe you're still sticking it between the mattresses. I doubt it. But but we all know what it's like to fill out a deposit slip, right? It's not enough to fill out a deposit slip. The bankers want to have something with that. Now, all of us understand also the technology today of direct deposit, where you don't even touch your money and it just goes into the account. Now, why am I using this metaphor? It's very important to understand. Just as it is in the natural, we need to grasp this mentally in the spirit. In the natural, if you place a demand on the deposit and there's not enough funds there, they're insufficient funds, your bank may be nice enough for one or two times to bless you and grace you and cover your overdraft. After that, they begin to charge you, correct? In the spirit, we must make sure that we're making the necessary deposits. So then, when life demands a withdrawal, there is something in your account that you can tap into, talk to me, tap into to meet the demand of the withdrawal. Often in the body of Christ, in the body of the Lord Jesus, we don't understand this language because we have embraced the mindset that God is always going to take care of me no matter what. There's truth to that, but there are certain circumstances that we find ourselves in that we completely collapse underneath its weight. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? In other words, an issue comes to us, and it has ravaging intent, catastrophic purpose. And it comes to us and against us. And if we do not have the necessary deposit inside of us, it will literally wreak havoc in us, upon us, around us, and can be extremely destructive. I'm going to give you an example or a question. How many of us in this room have ever had a friend that loved Jesus with all of his heart, soul, and mind, and they were in church, they were givers in the church, but something heavy came against them that completely overwhelmed them, and then you look up 6 months later, and you can't find them in the house of the Lord. They're no longer serving the Lord with the same exuberance. Anybody, I'm not talking about pointing at your spouse or anything, but you know somebody like that, all right? Okay, maybe just raise your hand if you know someone that was on fire for God, then something happened, and then now they go, well, Lord, I thought you were going to take care of that for me. Why did that happen to me? Where were you in that encounter? Now, these are all honest questions that we need to ask, correct? And we got to have answers to them. The devil is an evil devil. And at every turn that he wants to bring destruction, he wants to bring chaos into your life. So we have, in the last really 4 decades, we have presented to the American public a brand of Christianity where we come and we sit and we soak and we get blessed. We hear a few great words from the pastor, wonderful worship set, but we go out and we try to live off what we heard on Sunday morning, which is good, but not good enough. Because I'm come to tell you today that hard times are coming. Trouble is coming to all of us. And it is how you make it out of that trouble depends greatly upon the deposits that you have made in your life. Example, if you are loving God with all your heart, but all of a sudden you go to the doctor, you have pain in your left side, and you get a scan, and they find out that there's a tumor growing on the inside of you, and the report is not good. In fact, it's devastating, and it has rocked your world, it's rocked your children's world, it's rocked everybody's world. If you do not have enough deposit on the inside of you, and what type of deposit? Understanding the goodness of God, understanding that God is still God in the midst of our issues, understanding the healing covenant of the Lord Jesus Christ, of what Jesus purchased for us on the cross. If those are not deposited in you in great detail and in great quantity, when the waves of life come and splash on you and try to overtake you, a tsunami of trouble, then what's going to happen? It's going to deplete the deposit that you've made. You may have enough to stand for a month or two, but if you have not dug down deep and anchored into the Word of God about His goodness and about His power and about His strength, it will literally overwhelm you. And then you're saying, God, you've got to help me. And He's going to do all he can, and He will come to help you. But He wants you to use what you have deposited to, watch this, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. If you do not have enough resistance on the inside of you, and he knows that you are weak in particular areas, he will come and he will pound and he will pound and he will pound and he will pound until he breaks through the barrier. Now, I don't have time because I've got to turn this over to Karen, but I want to say to our KINEO students this morning, what you guys have literally underwent the last year, 9 months of your life, is depositing. You have deposited beyond the Sunday school teacher environment. You have went to a completely different level than just coming to church and hearing what the pastor says for 30 minutes. Most pastors speak in generalities because the audience is so vast. We've got small children to someone that may be 99 years of age, someone that's been saved a month, someone that's been saved for 66 years. So we speak just throwing it out in the middle, hoping that it lands somewhere. But KINEO is more than that because it is extremely targeted and it is laser-like to build deposits in your life. Now, next Sunday and the following weeks, I'm going to be talking about the five accounts that you must deposit in order to be able to resist the devil and be able to stand strong in the face of trials. You don't want to miss that. So we're going to be talking about deposits. Now, the Bible says this. Karen, you can come on up. The Bible says this, that my people perish for what? My people what? Perish for lack of knowledge. It is not that God doesn't want to come to your aid, and he will do all that he can. But sometimes we don't make it because of a lack of knowledge. Knowledge is power. Knowledge can either save your life and or extend your life. Knowledge. Do not mix water with electricity. How many of y'all believe that little bit of knowledge can save your life? You're a painter. Watch the overhead lines. Carrying a ladder. There's juice in them, their lines. That's a good bit of information to know if you are a painter. Knowledge can save your life or extend your life. Do not throw gasoline on the fire. How many of y'all think that's a good bit of a piece of knowledge to know when you're trying to start a fire? My people perish. Now watch this. Because of a lack of knowledge, there are certain things that God just expects us to handle. And without the rightful knowledge, you can't make a withdrawal if there's been no deposit. That's why I'm so proud of these KINEO students, that you have taken an entire year of sacrifice, getting here, online students, all of you, and doing what it has literally, what has been required of you to deposit. Are all of you better and stronger and more knowledgeable and more usable after this last year of spending under our teacher, Karen? How many of you would say that? Yes. Praise God. So I want to turn it over to our president of KINEO Ministry Training Center, and let me just make one statement that I think is very important. KINEO Ministry Training Center for this year, right now, there are over, I think, 190 students around the country and here at the North Georgia Revival in this year of KINEO 1 and KINEO 2. So would you stand to your feet and help me welcome our president, Miss Karen Smith.
Continue to give a round of applause to our graduates this morning, our 2019 KINEO 1 graduates. January through September was their school year. You may be seated this morning. Thank you so much for joining us and allowing us this time to celebrate them. The Lord loves celebration. He also loves honor. So we honor the Lord Jesus Christ this morning, and we also honor our precious students and their accomplishments. I want to welcome again all of our guests of our students. And also, I would like to at this time recognize the elders of Christ Fellowship Church. If our elder team will please stand, if you're in the building. Pastor, there's Brent. Okay, guys, stand. Mr. Rudy, perfect. Thank you all so much. Thank you, gentlemen, so much. If you are staff and support staff of Christ Fellowship Church, will you please stand? And your spouse, all the spouses and support staff and staff, thank you so much, Christ Fellowship Church staff and support team. Thank you so much. We got Pastors Mark and Retta in the back with our babies. They're back there celebrating with us. So great to have them with us in the building. Thank you so very much. Pastor Todd's been talking this morning about depositing, and he is right. In the midnight hour, you have to know what to do when the enemy comes and things hit. We have to be equipped in and of ourselves to be able to handle things, to be able to push through and get the victory. I was standing right down here, I think it was Sunday night or maybe two Sunday nights ago, I can't remember, and I was praying for a particular student, a former KINEO student. She graduated in June of this year. And her name is Sherry Lamb, and Sherry came, and she said, I just need you to agree in prayer with me. She needed healing, and the Lord healed her. I've been checking on her periodically. She had some a case in her nose and sinuses, and just a long story, but the Lord healed her right down here the other night as we just agreed in prayer. She came in faith knowing the Lord was going to heal her. She said, I just need you to agree with me, and I said, we can do it right here. So we prayed, and she was healed, and again, I've been checking on her. She's still healed. But she had heard Pastor Todd's message on deposits that Sunday. So I guess it was last Sunday night that this happened. You lose track of time during revival, don't you? And so she said, you know, I listened to his sermon about, because he talked last week about depositing emotionally. Y'all remember that? For those of you who are here, he talked about depositing in the emotional account. He's covering five accounts that we must deposit into. So last week he talked about the emotional account. And Sherry said something very important. And I called her yesterday and I asked her permission. Could I use this quote? Because I said, it's going to step right into our graduation ceremony. Can I use the quote that you said? And she said, sure. And she talked about with me that night how she had come to a place in her life. It was a very intense, stressful place in her life. And she said one night she had cried out. All night long, and she said, I was crying out to the Lord. She said, I became very numb, just almost sore in my body. And she said, for a period of time, I went through a time in my life where I was emotionally numb. Now, listen to what I'm going to say. She said, I was emotionally numb. She said, I didn't feel God. I didn't feel the Holy Spirit. She said, I didn't feel anything. And she said, when that happened, I had to move over and to tap into something else. And this is what she said. I knew God was there for me, so I had to live off my knowledge account to sustain me while my emotional account was undergoing healing. Isn't that good? She said, I had to rely on my knowledge account, and that I'm sure is going to be an account that Pastor Todd covers, but I had to rely on my knowledge account while my emotional account was being healed. And that's what these precious students have done this year, and that's what many of you have done, and that's what many of you are going to start to do, is to make deposits into your knowledge account. Because Sherry went on to say, I had to lean into what I knew God's word said. I had to lean into what I knew God said about me. I had to lean into what I knew the promises of God were. Because she said, I wasn't feeling anything. Isn't that good? So guys, again, as Pastor was talking about this morning, there are many accounts that we must deposit into. And KINEO Ministry Training Center helps us make that deposit into our knowledge. There's nothing wrong with knowledge as long as it pushes you closer to Jesus and equips you more to tell others about Christ. Amen? So we just celebrate Sherry this morning and her testimony about her account of knowledge. Well, this year with these precious students, I've said it many times and I'll say it again this way. They stepped into KINEO during a time when revival and most all of them, if not all of them, in some shape, form, or fashion are involved in revival. They stepped into a time when revival was kind of kicking into a higher gear. So for them to participate in KINEO, they put something else on their plate. Now, we've also got many of our online students that are with us, but they're even involved in revival. We've got some that have been involved in mission trips. Our Arizona campus, you guys raise your hands. There's our Arizona campus. They're with us this morning. They're involved in revival. And so what's happened at the North Georgia Revival has impacted them, all of our students, I believe, in some shape, form, or fashion. And so I just want to share some of the comments that I collected from them toward the end of the year in regard to how KINEO has helped them or influenced them. And there's nothing like hearing from the students themselves. And so just to lead off here, Jessica Bice, she said, KINEO is life-changing in every way. I was a beginner Bible reader, and it was hard to understand. I wasn't feeling alive when I was reading. KINEO gave me the life, the understanding, the purpose, the detail, the personal experience I was looking for. Now the Bible is my book of life. Isn't that incredible? Vicki Uselton, she said, I don't have words to describe how KINEO changed my prayer life, my worship, and how I study. The spiritual growth I have experienced in the past 9 months has been incredible. This is Julie. The blood covenant class changed my life. I learned how to pray in authority over each situation in my life using blood covenant promises or prayers that I have full legal access to pray. Makes all the difference in the world when you pray according to the covenant. Amen. This is Ken from our Arizona campus. We have a class called Communion with God. And you know, the Lord speaks to us, but sometimes we don't know it's Him. Because there's four voices: your voice, the voice of the world, the voice of the enemy, and the voice of God. And sometimes you can have a fleeting thought or a fleeting voice pass through your heart or your mind, and you think, oh, it's just me. Well, it didn't even sound like us. Sometimes it's God. And so Ken said in the Communion with God class, I learned that God has been speaking to me. Isn't that good? Andy Holbrook, he loved the New Testament survey. He said, that was my favorite class. I love Jesus, and each time I read the scriptures, something new appears. This is Todd Scaff. He's one of our Arizona campus students. He said, growing in my understanding of the covenant we are in with God has added so much faith to my walk. It showed me who I really am in Him in deep and new ways. This is Susan Gifford. She attends Flowery Branch, but she came to Dawsonville to attend school here with us. So she's at Pastor David Edmondson's church. She said, the Communion with God class gave me incredible tools to increase and deepen my prayer life and really listen for the voice of God. Two more. This is Kimberly Craig. Kimberly serves in our revival team, of course. She says, a game changer truth for me was when Pastor Karen diagrammed for us the concept of us being in Him. Yes, He's in us, but knowing that we are in Him gives me a greater confidence to combat fear. Isn't that incredible? And then also, from Tiffany Hill, one truth I will never forget that I learned in KINEO is that He is bound to me, and I am bound to Him. He chooses to be with me forever. He partners with me, and I should partner with Him. Amen. Give the students a hand clap. There are so many other comments I could share this morning, but that just lets you know a little bit of their heart and what KINEO meant to them. Well, we know that revival changed everything. Remember this event. Many of you were there that day. Many of you have seen this picture. And this is when the Holy Spirit began to sit down in Christ Fellowship Church and in our community. Do you know, Paula, am I correct? This is the only picture we have of this day. And Paula captured this on her phone. This is when the Holy Spirit came on Pastor Todd, and we saw things begin to happen and to move. This is in February 2018, and we've been going ever since. The vision that the Lord gave him, a fire on the water, got everything started. And we've kind of learned along the way, feeling our way along the way. And Sherry says it so brilliantly all the time. She says, He's going to help us. That's what Sherry always tells us, Sherry Potts. She says, He's going to help us. He's going to help us. And He has helped us. But what we learned very, very quickly is that revival causes us to be about preparation. There are many people that come into this building that need help and need urgent care and urgent prayer and need a kind word. And so revival has kicked us into a higher gear of that. Many of us, we've done marketplace ministry. We talk to people on the job. We talk to people in Kroger. We're sharing with our family. But guys, you know as well as I do that revival has caused the world to come in. And so many students have looked around and said, you know, I'm going to be involved in KINEO because I know that KINEO is not all about just me. I've got to prepare myself for others. So KINEO is not just for us and just about us. Boy, if I could drive any nail into the board this morning, it would be that right there. Preparation is not just for us. Preparation is for other people that you're going to come in contact with either within the four walls of this church or in the marketplace or on your job or in the airport wherever your life takes you, wherever the Lord takes you, it's all about being prepared because, as I've said many times, we live in a culture that it's not enough to say, I love Jesus. That's not enough. Somebody's going to come to you and say, why? And what makes him so special? Well, he's the way, the truth, and the life. How do you know? Amen? I love this quote by Bill Johnson. It's probably my favorite quote that I've heard him say. The Holy Spirit comes in you for you, but he comes upon you for someone else. We are equipped. We're filled with the Holy Spirit. We're touched by the things of God. We're touched by the miracles of God. We're touched by the Word of God, yes, for us and to build us and to equip us. But guys, really, the Holy Spirit comes in us for us. He saves us for us, but he comes upon us for us, but for others as well. And so these students have stepped into that preparation of being prepared and ready when the time came for ministry. Revival brought us a few things. It created a sense of urgency on the inside of all of us. With this class here, what had happened pretty much was there was such a wave of students that came in for the September to June class. Our staff looked around, and Sherry really spoke into this. We all looked around and said, there's a lot of students that missed the registration for September. We gotta kick it into a higher gear and start another class. There's so many more that want to come along. That is how this class got started. I've never had a class January to September. I've never done that. We've always stayed on track with a regular school year. But there was such a sense of urgency that people wanted to get prepared and equipped, serving on the revival teams or being out in the marketplace, coming into contact with people that have needs and realizing, man, I need to know more. And so there was a sense of urgency that was created, and KINEO answered that. We all became aware of the fact that we are so responsible. We are so responsible with what we know in the Lord. I actually heard a minister, I was listening to a podcast the other day, he actually said this. He said, we owe Jesus miracles. We owe him miracles. And when that minister said that, I thought, man, are you kidding me right now? Well, did he not come and show us how to pray for the sick, how to see the miracles happen? So, guys, in all reality, and I'll speak on this in a moment, when Jesus laid aside his, not his godness necessarily, but my point is that he did everything that he did as one of us. And so if he can bring in the miracle, then we can bring in the miracle. Amen? Now, I don't know how many of us have lived that way, but that is the truth. He came on this earth. One of his purposes was to show us how to do it. Amen? And so we have a vast responsibility. And also revival awakened us to the possibilities of having and living an empowered life. We can be and should be living totally empowered by the Holy Spirit and walking in that and then touching other lives with that very thing. Pastor Todd quotes this passage often. It's the story where the young child could not be healed by the disciples. And the passage reads, so I spoke to your disciples and that they should cast it out, but they could not. This is what we don't want to ever be said about anyone in our church, anyone within the reach of KINEO Ministry Training Center, that we could not go out and do the work of the ministry, that we could not go out and do what the Lord has commanded us to do. Amen? And wasn't it Jesus that came, as I was speaking just a moment ago, as our prototype? Guys, this is it right here. Jesus came and he laid his ability to do things as God aside. He laid that aside because many of us can look at that and say, well, of course Jesus healed him. He's God. But over in the book of Philippians, it clearly says that he laid that aside and he stepped into a flesh and bone body. empowered by the Holy Spirit, in perfect union with the Father, only saying what the Father said, only doing what the Father did, and He showed us exactly the life that we are to live. That's what a prototype is. It is an explanation of the of more of this type to come, but it's the first one. Prototype. It's the first one of more models like this to come. And so, yes, we are to lay hands on the sick and see them recovered. We are to lay hands on the demonized and see them free. We are to go to the lost man and take him to the foot of the cross and see him born again. We've got to get this, because long gone are the days where we just look and go, well, Jesus did it because he was God. No, he did it as man. That's why his humanity is so important to understand, that he came wrapped in flesh just like you and I to do the things that he's charged us to do. We realize that we cannot change theology or develop a new belief system to answer the questions resulting from our impotence. That's where, well, I guess it's God's will came from. Because the believer can't get it done in the person's life, and so we blame God and say, well, I guess it's not his will for you to be healed. Well, when I pray for people, they don't always get healed. Well, pray again. Well, it's not working. Well, pray again. One of the great healing evangelists of our day and time, Randy Clark. Sherry, was it Randy Clark or was it Chris Gore that prayed for the 1,000? I think it was Chris Gore, but one of those individuals prayed for 1,000 people before they saw them healed. Anybody. But this is what we can't do, is develop a brand new, well, let's just come up with something to answer that question, why that person's not free. Let's just make something up. We're not going to do that, because Jesus is the prototype. And we've learned in KINEO that he came to give us a better covenant. That we are in relationship with someone that shed blood for us, gave us blood promises, gave us blood power, gave us blood authority. We learn that he is in us and we are in him, right, Kim? And we're not going anywhere and he's not going anywhere. We've learned that he speaks to us, often through the spontaneous flow of thought, and gives us direction every single day. And we walk according to the word, because now we understand it and we know how to navigate through it, because we were introduced to Mr. Strong. Amen? And we can tell you what the devil is like just through the word serpent and just through the word devil. And we can tell you how God says in the word, he says, let God rule and reign in your life like a what? Umpire. Because we've met Mr. Strong. All of these wonderful things in KINEO Ministry Training Center this year. These folks are equipped. I'll stand them up to anything. Because if they can't do it by themselves, they'll pull in a team member and they'll get that thing done. And may it never be said of a KINEO Ministry Training Center student, they could not. Because they can. And they will continue to do it. They'll continue to minister in powerful, powerful ways. Amen? Amen. Well, let's honor these wonderful students this morning. And we're going to honor them through the giving of diplomas and certificates this morning. What I'd like to ask you to do is hold your applause. There's quite a few of them. So, Miss Teresa, if you and Kim will come, and Pastor Todd, if you'll come, he's going to assist me this morning. And thank you, gentlemen, if you'll take your places at the steps. As I said, guys, it's been tough on these students this year, and so we applaud them this morning. One thing I will tell you is that our class met on Mondays. Wow. After many of them stayed up all night long at revival serving, they went into work on Mondays oftentimes and then had to come to KINEO, or got to come to KINEO. And so that Monday night class was tough. It was tough, but they did it. Amen. So, without any other delay, first we have Miss Teresa Kane. Teresa's from South Carolina, an online student receiving the certificate of participation this morning. Congratulations, Miss Teresa. We have two individuals that are not with us this morning, but I do want to recognize them. Aaron Corsi and his sweet brand new wife, Miss Stephanie Corsi. They are away this morning, but they also will receive the certificate of participation. Next, we have Miss Kimberly Diaz receiving the certificate of participation. So give these folks a round of applause this morning. Certificates of participation. Now for the full-on diploma of biblical theology, these students did everything that was required of them academically and service-wise to receive the diploma of biblical theology. All students, all KINEO students that receive this diploma serve 50 hours of practicum time. Now many of them got that like the first month, because they're all hours of the night in revival. It hasn't always been that way, but we want to honor these precious people this morning. First, we have Lauren Anderson. Lauren's on our baptism team, served in children's camp. Next, Miss Jessica Bice. Again, serving so faithfully. Hillary Cochran. Many of these ladies, of course, have children at home. Hillary and her husband, children at home. So sometimes you have to work around that, but they did that. Excellent job. Miss Roxanna Collins. Roxanna is from Savannah. That's easy. Roxanna from Savannah. She's our missionary. Did a lot of traveling. So we celebrate Roxanna this morning. Amen. Rebecca Connolly. Diploma of Biblical Theology, served in our youth ministry. Miss Kimberly Craig, serves in our revival team. Her husband, Sean, and their five children. You've got five children? Is that five, right? Five children. Wow. Amen. Mr. Daniel Elliott, precious couple right here, serving on our baptism team in other areas. And his sweet wife, Miss Katie, who went to Africa during KINEO this year. So wonderful. And this is their mom, or Daniel's mom, Miss Lolly Elliott. She works on our baptism team. If you ever need 150 to 200 towels, Miss Lolly's your hookup. She can get you some towels. She did that for our team. Miss Sheena Elliott. Come on up, Miss Sheena. Serves on our teams as well. You'll see her oftentimes late in the night in that baptism waters. God bless you guys. Thank y'all. Isn't it neat to see a whole family? I'll get in there. They'd scrap over stuff. Have fun. Miss Susan Gifford, Covenant Connections Church, baptism team. Curtis Hill. Come on up, Curtis. Serves faithfully here. Served in children's camp this year. And then his sweet wife, Miss Tiffany. Come on up, Tiffany Hill. Again, all these folks serve. So faithful, all of our students this year. Mr. Andy Holbrook. Andy leads a small group. Serves on our baptism team. And then many of you may have seen this lady in action, Miss Joanne Holbrook. Come on up, Miss Joanne. The prophetic artist of the house. This lady paints with her fingers. What? You got to see her artwork in the lobby. Amen. Miss Michaela Kennedy. Michaela came in as a student, and now she's my assistant. That's the way to get it done. Amen. So now Michaela is on our staff. It's great to have her with us. Miss Tony Knapp. Come on up, Tony. She's an online student from Coming. Participates in revival as well. Now, the first of our Arizona students, Kenneth Kneister. Come on up, Ken. He's a drummer at their church, at Cornerstone Church in Arizona. So we celebrate him today. Also from Arizona, Joel Lobaugh. Joel serves faithfully in that church as well. These are some of the key leaders in our Arizona church, our Arizona campus. Miss Mariah Long, of course, she's home, folk. Serves with our children. I think during KINEO, Mariah, wasn't it, that the Lord confirmed the call in your life? Okay, you'll hear more about that. So we're excited for her. Pastor Samuel Lundgren, come on up, Pastor Samuel. And his precious wife, Pastor Sandra. These are the lead pastors of Cornerstone Church in Cottonwood, Arizona, who now have a KINEO campus. So we celebrate them today. They are carrying revival all through Arizona with these precious team leaders of theirs. And so we are excited to see what God is going to do. This team is also taking KINEO 2, and they are the poster children for KINEO in the state of Arizona. They're pushing it hard for a new KINEO 1 class. So we're excited about that. This is their daughter, Miss Sarah. Come on up, Sarah. She knows a little bit about everything. Technology, photography, so we celebrate her this morning. Perfect job. This is Mr. Zach Mathis. Come on up, Zach. You'll often see Zach praying over the pool late into the night. Raul Medina Mora. Come on up, Raul. Precious KINEO student, did well this year. So proud of him. Got a call of God on his life as well. Miss Sherry Nelson is not with us this morning, but we want to celebrate Sherry. She will also receive the Diploma of Biblical Theology. See her there in the yellow top. So we celebrate her. Matthew Pollock, this is our soldier. Safe and sound back from Afghanistan. Did KINEO on the field in Afghanistan. Can you say no excuse? No excuse. Led a small group while he was there. And finished strong. Yes. So proud of Matthew. Thank you, Matt, for serving our nation. Now he and Abby will be in KINEO 2 together. So we're excited about that. Lori Rafus. Come on up, Lori. Part of our baptism team. Serve faithfully in the back with Miss Sherry. Jessica Sawyer. Come on up, Jessica. Serves all over the house during revival and at her home church as well. So we celebrate her this morning. Two of our Arizona students were not able to be with us, but we celebrate them. This is Todd Scaff. He is the associate pastor at Cornerstone. And so we celebrate Todd, precious young man, loves to hunt. For all you hunters, loves to hunt. And then his sweet wife, Sarah. So we celebrate them this morning, even though they couldn't be with us. They are going to watch or are watching, I'm sure. Next, we have Mr. Chris Taylor, all the way from Flowery Branch. Come on up, Chris. He's our online student. Faithful to join us every week. He would always click on my phone. I'm here. I'm here. Miss Vicki Uselton. Come on up, Vicki. Serves on our baptism team. Precious lady. Her husband will start year one next year, and she will start year two. Next, we have Julie Van Hallinger. Come on up, Julie. Julie is a school teacher, and so she would be in the classroom teaching all week and then come in on Monday nights and get taught. And a very seasoned young lady, enjoyed having her with us. Miss Brittany Wood, another online student, local online student, serving in the revival, and also her husband, Merrill Wood. Come on up, Merrill. Sweet couple, faithful to serve. And last but certainly not least, Miss Vicki Young. This is Vicki, who benefited so much from KINEO. She often shared with me how the Lord was showing her special things all year long. And so we celebrate Vicki this morning. Give them one more hand clap of celebration today. Job well done. Yes. All you former KINEO students, you know what it was like. Yes. Thank you, guys. You may be seated. I have three more awards, and then we'll draw a conclusion here in just a moment to our graduation ceremony. But before I give out those special awards, let me just recognize some folks that are kind of behind the scenes but helped me tremendously this year. And I don't want to go, another moment without recognizing them. And so as I call your name, there are five of you individuals. As I call your name, if you'll just come and approach the stage, and I'm going to hand something special for you to Pastor Todd. He'll get that to you. But let me just thank these few people very, very quickly. This first young lady helped me in the classroom. She would always text or call, do you need anything? And initially I asked her, hey, can you come clean the classroom before everybody gets here? Can you just wipe down tables and maybe run the vacuum cleaner? Because, you know, sometimes in the week there's just not time for that. And so I needed that help, and she was always so willing to come and do that for me, and just willing to help and serve her classmates in that capacity, whatever I needed. So I just want to thank Ms. Sheena Elliott this morning for doing that for us. Thank you, Sheena. This next individual, I've already mentioned her, but she came in as a student and then just kind of jumped in and took a lead and came right alongside me to help me finish out the year. Always stayed late with me, always asked if there was something I needed, and then I hired her. I hired her. There's a long story behind that, and it's pretty funny. Maybe I'll share it one day. But Miss Michaela, come on up. Thank you, Michaela, for helping out so much. She'll probably run her own Bible school one day. This next individual is very precious to me because it's my son, Ty. So, Ty, you're in the back. Come on out. Ty worked all year long serving in KINEO 1, the first one, then the Kingdom Now class, and then this class, doing all the technology, everything online, all the camera work, all the recording, all the posting. Got here, loaded videos for me, got here early, stayed late if I needed him to, and helped me out in an area that I'm not real familiar with. So I appreciate Ty so much. So Ty Smith, if you'll come and grab that for me. Just wanted to say thank you for all your hard work. He went above and beyond. These last two ladies are the brains. Couldn't make it without them. Because they really have hands-on connection to KINEO, watching all the P's and the Q's for me. Again, something that I don't have a whole lot of time to do. And so this first gal just keeps the records for me. She does all that bookkeeping and all the grade recording, and she's a great soundboard and just excellent assistant. So Miss Carrie Caller, where are you? Oh, there she is. Come on up, Carrie. I love Carrie because she never panics. I like people that don't panic. I mean, I'll tell her something. She goes, well, we got it. It's good. Don't worry about it. It's going to be okay. And this next lady is a precious friend of mine, also a coworker, but a great sounding board. She had a lot to do with prayerfully helping us kind of move forward into this class, spoke into that prophetically, and just love being with her. Again, she's Carrie is her assistant, but they always have their eyes on the things of KINEO for me, things that I can't watch. So I appreciate her so much, Miss Sherry Potts. Don't you love her? I mean, isn't she great? And again, I wanted to say thank you to, again, to our wonderful Christ Fellowship staff. Pastor Marty always gets my back when I can't figure something out on the computer or when I need an extra hand here, an extra hand there. He's always there. Of course, Pastor Todd, my Todd, is our greatest cheerleaders in support of KINEO. And so I appreciate these two gentlemen being the leaders and heading out way out in front of me and dreaming and thinking of KINEO. And also, you know, our revival pastors. I just appreciate them so much supporting KINEO and talking about KINEO. I remember one night Pastor Robbie Mathis was preaching, and he literally promoted KINEO. This is a pastor from another church. Nobody does this. But you do it when you're in revival and you're unified. Yeah, and you've learned that Jesus blesses unity, but he's a pastor from Freedom Tabernacle. He stands on this platform, and he promoted our school, knowing that in just a few months, he was going to start his own school. Isn't that something? And boy, that just blessed my heart. So I acknowledge our revival pastors this morning so much, and just thank them for supporting KINEO. Well, lastly, I just want to recognize three very special students. Perfect attendance is hard to do because you know what? Life gets in the way. But two individuals this year pushed through and had had the perfect attendance. And this first individual actually had a chance to go down to Pensacola and be in the celebration of the revival, revival's past. But he had a KINEO class that week. And he said, if I miss it, I mess up my perfect attendance, and I won't be able to be in class, and I won't finish. And so he turned that opportunity down to sit in KINEO and take his last class, and that's Andy Holbrooks. And this next one is no surprise, because this is just how she is. She's going to do it this way and no other way, and that's perfect attendance, and that's Michaela Kennedy. Come on up, Michaela. And our last special award this morning goes to an individual who earned the highest academic average in the class out of everyone, the highest academic average. And so this special award goes to Miss Kimberly Craig. It was very close. It was very, very close. So now, Kim, you should hang this in your kitchen and point to that with all your five children and say it can be done. Amen? All right, one more time. Hand clap of celebration. Amen? Congratulations, students.
Praise God. Stand to your feet, if you would, all across the room. Karen, I want to thank you. I want to thank your staff and leading us to be able to make great deposits. Hallelujah. What a remarkable morning. People ask, well, why do you take a Sunday morning to do something like this? And here's the reason why. Church is not about an event. It's about a process. And I celebrate process. We're a church of process. I celebrate that. KINEO are the legs, if not the back, the shoulders of what God has placed the revival on. Our elders, our staff, support teams, KINEO. God will only place the level of glory on us that we can manage. And greater the deposit, greater the glory. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you for this remarkable morning where we have felt you, seen you, and celebrated you and edified and encouraged your people. With great faith, I am anticipating 2019 and 2020 in the KINEO Ministry Training Center to be the best, the most fruitful, the most dynamic that we've ever seen. But tonight, come, Lord Jesus. Have your way. In Jesus' name. Now listen to me before I dismiss you. I got a text yesterday from a dear friend of mine who is a pastor. He said, I am sending three people to your church tonight. We're traveling around 200 miles to be here. In fact, they're probably on the road right now. One of which the doctor has given up on and said there's no need for you even to take chemo any further. He said, just enjoy the time that you have left. Three cancer patients are riding in one van tonight to be in this room. One of which has days to live. Days to live. place yourself on the van passing the Alabama-Georgia state line, and with every crossing, listen, every mile that ticks on the odometer, will God meet me in the water? Will I see my daughter graduate? Will I be able to walk her down the aisle? That's what's coming to this building tonight. It's not kids' play. It's not a take it or leave it mindset. And when he gets out of that van, he's going to be 300 feet, 100 yards from that water. And while we're praying at 5 to 6, his eyes will not leave that water. And he says, maybe this is the time. And every step that he takes as he's listening to the worship and the preaching, and as he gets closer and he takes his walk on these steps, his eyes will never leave the water. Sherry, as your team hold him, hear your clothes. As the team prays for him, he's thinking, is this a moment? Guys, we are in an unprecedented moment in time in our church. Come pray at 5 o'clock today. No pool party is more important than the glory of God that is happening here. No last moment on the lake is more important than what this is tonight. Imagine that being your father, your brother. I'm not manipulating you, I'm just telling you the truth. He's coming. And two other cancer patients with him. Can all of us agree together to come back tonight at 5 and pray? Father, help me. Help me. May I not be found missing in the greatest move that we have ever experienced in my life and in this church's history, in this area. God, help our church, the greatest people. Help us to host you well. Help me. Oh God, I'm so weak. But help me. Help me lead well. Help us serve you, oh God. And all God's people said amen. 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 Guests, if you're here for the first time, come see Karen and I and our team at the guest reception room. Go right through that door. Take a right, first door on the right. God bless you. Thank you for being here. See you tonight at 5 o'clock for prayer. 6 o'clock our revival service.